Hello, I'm Saukki. Some time ago, I made a video about how to make your velomobile faster. In that video, I said this.
And then number three, wheel covers. Because basically the wheel and the spokes are like a big fan rotating the air inside the wheel well. So by adding this kind of wheel cover, you stop the air rotating so much inside the wheel well. Of course, it doesn't completely stop the air from moving inside the wheel well, but it helps.
But in the comment section of that video, someone pointed out that a wheel cover only on one side of the wheel in a closed wheel well, like the Quest has, may actually be more inefficient. There was also a link to a German Velomobile forum where someone has made some tests. I put the link to that thread in the video description. I don't understand German very well and the Google translator is, well, you know what it is. So I want to do my own test. So today I'm going to test if the Quest is faster without the wheel covers. But before we start, I want to point out that this is only a problem with the closed wheel well, like the Quest has here. Of course, with the open wheel well, like Strada or DF, you need some kind of wheel cover, so it's more aerodynamic that way. But if I understand correctly, with this kind of closed wheel well, the best case scenario would be a wheel cover on both sides of the wheel. But then there is the problem with the brake cooling, because the brakes need some airflow to cool down. So that's why we don't see wheel covers on both sides of the wheel, because that may be dangerous, especially in hilly area. So if the guy in the German Velomobile forum is right, I should be faster without these standard wheel covers. So let's go out and test. I checked the tire pressure, so there should be same pressure on all tires. But that's not important because I'm going to do all the tests after each other, so I think the tire pressure is not going to change between the tests. But then there's just one thing I have to do before I go. I have to do the power meter zero offset calibration. Calibrating. Okay, now it's complete. And then, just let's go. Okay, so about the test procedure, this is what I have in mind. I have here a few kilometers long piece of road. It's mostly flat and my plan is to ride this road at the speed of 50 kilometers per hour and then see what kind of power readings I get. And I was thinking that the difference in power between wheel covers and without wheel covers may not be so much. So I was thinking that maybe I get more difference if I go faster, so that's why let's try. I can ride 50 kilometers per hour and hopefully that's fast enough so we can get definite answer which one is faster. Okay, so let me show you my test procedure. Okay, so plan is this. I accelerate here at the downhill and try to get close to 50 kilometers per hour before end of the hill. And then start a new lap here at this point. Okay. And now let's try to keep the power close to 50 kilometers per hour. And then finally, let's see the average power for every run. I just try to keep the speed steady at 50 kilometers per hour or close to it, so the average speed should be as close to 50 kilometers per hour as possible. And let's stop the lap here where the speed limit changed to 40 kilometers per hour. And here. Okay, then let's go for another run. Now let's do maybe at least 4 runs more, then we can get more reliable results. Okay, so now I just take the wheel covers off and I store them inside the velomobile, so there will be no weight difference. Okay, now 5 runs without wheel covers. And according to that guy in German Velomobile forum, this should be more efficient. Which means that I should need less power to keep the speed of 50 kilometers per hour. So, let's see.
day, so all tests are done now. Actually, I didn't feel any big difference, so I think that so it would be very interesting to see the results. So let's go and see them.
Okay, so let's see the results. This is going to be very interesting because, as I said, I didn't feel any difference between the runs. So if there is difference, it must be very small. Okay, so I have the results here in Strava. Now, because I started a new lap at the start and at the end of the test road, I have here the lap data. And here the laps 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10 are the test runs. I'm interested about the average power of these runs. And that can be found here. But let's also take note of the average speed, just for a reference. And by the way, here we can also see that the test piece was 3.7 kilometers long and the elevation difference was about minus 10 meters. And that means that the average grade of the road was less than minus 0.3%. So it's almost flat. I collected the results here in this spreadsheet. Here on the left I have the 5 runs with wheel covers and on the right the 5 runs without wheel covers. And here at the bottom line are the averages of these 5 runs. And we can see the difference isn't much. It's actually only 2 watts. But according to this, I use it 2 watts more when riding without the wheel covers. And by the way, the average speed was almost identical in both tests. But I bet the margin of error is greater than 2 watts. So I think it's safe to say that there was no difference between the tests. And I think that's quite surprising. I didn't want to believe this test, so I figured out that maybe the test road wasn't flat enough. There were a few very small hills, or should I say gradients. So I decided to examine these results again and only use the last kilometer of the test road, because that seemed to be the most flat part of the road. With the Strava analysis tool, I can select part of the road I want, and then it shows the data for that part only. And here we can see the average speed and power. I collected this data again here in the spreadsheet, and what did I found out? There is even less difference, only 0.4 watts. But this time, it seems that I used 0.4 watts less power when riding without the wheel covers. And again, the average speeds are pretty close to each other. There are a few variables that may affect to these results, like the wind. I didn't note the wind direction or force, but those may have been changing during the test. Also the air temperature and humidity may have been changing and those also affect to aerodynamics. And then I'm not sure how accurate my power meter or GPS bike computer are. So keep these things in mind when looking at these results. So the conclusion is that these standard wheel covers doesn't make you faster nor slower. But I figured out that maybe when these covers are attached to the wheels, they increase the rotating mass and that mass maybe takes more power to accelerate. So that's why I haven't been using the wheel covers anymore. And the other thing is that without the covers, I can get easier access to the tire valve.
But so, that's all for today. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video. Bye bye!